Okay, I've reduced this file down to a size that I want it to be on my website. So what can I do to optimize this even further?
Well, that's a great question, Brian, and I've got an answer for you with Photoshop. It's under the File menu, and it is called Save for Web and Devices.
Okay.
This area is designed to provide you in a 4-up view, a 2-up view, optimized and original view, and your tabs up there, to let you use the presets that are built into Photoshop to get optimization ready for the web on your image. Let's do a 4-up. We're going to use a preset. You can also have options within those presets under GIF, JPEG, PNG, for example.
Okay, yeah, I want to be a JPEG.
Okay, let's go set that preset, Brian.
Okay.
You can set either one of those to JPEG medium, probably, to begin with.
Okay.
Is a good place to start.
And then what's it showing me here?
It's showing you.
This is my original.
That's right.
This is a little bit smaller, I guess. Yeah, well, here's file size here. And then I guess this is the speed it's being transferred at, how long it'll take. So this is my file size if I use this setting.
Exactly.
Okay.
And it defaulted to a 30 quality,
mm-hmm.
which you can even change that on the fly if you want to.
So if I still want to be a little better than that.
Exactly.
I can make
so
it
that's
50.
The one you have selected on. It's a little hard to see that selection, but it kind of highlights around the square of that 4-up image
uh-huh.
there.
Yeah.
If you'll move your cursor down and click on that bottom, that highlights that one, and you can either leave it as GIF or go ahead and find another preset in there.
So PNG in there.
And you'll start seeing some options in there. Now you want to check your speed rate, so you might do that little menu
drop
down.
Yeah, so this is going to take longer than that one, and we're not getting that much improvement in quality, so this is still the winner so far. Okay.
Right. And if you need to zoom in a little bit on that, you can do it at the bottom, Brian.
And just get
a little bit better picture of all of them together.
Oh, I see. Yeah.
So, obviously, JPEG is the setting you normally want for a good quality photo. PNG is very good at translating photographic images as well. But you know that it is the web, and you want that speed.
Yeah,
so
we want to go fast. We don't
want
people waiting on images to load.
GIF is not the best setting for a continuous tone photo such as we have here.
Yeah, I can see I could put these lines in it.
That's right, mm-hmm. because it's index color. If you'll look at the color table to your right, there's only a certain amount of colors that are referencing in that photograph.
So it's
losing.
So
it's banding. It's not giving you
right.
the full quality. So JPEG or PNG sounds like something that's going to work great for you.
Yeah, JPEG didn't look that much. You wouldn't know it looked any worse if you weren't sitting there comparing it.
That's right.
So this looks really good.
At 19K,
yeah, it's
I
tiny.
Know the programmers are going to be happy with you, Brian, and the web is going to speed right along.
All
right,
so I could just, now that I've clicked that, so I hit save to save it, or?
Yes, go right ahead and save that.
Oh,
and
okay.
And then it'll be
oh,
ready
so it's
for
a new,
you.
It's a copy. It doesn't
That's
save
right.
over it.
That's
okay.
right. This has been in a lot of versions of Photoshop. I'm glad that you asked the question. I'm wanting a lot of people to know about this option and use it on a regular basis to get those files optimized for the web.